Today we're going to take a look at Mincer's CPC-8000 high-end pressure controller, a premium accuracy instrument suitable in a factory or working standard as a calibration solution for various applications. Its control performance is particularly notable thanks to patented valve technology and the accurate internal transducers. Let's start with the labels here on the rear panel. This is where you'll find information labels with the serial number, pressure ranges, and date of manufacturing. Warning: it's important not to block the fan because it will affect the internal temperature of the controller. There are 6 pressure connections located across the rear panel. On the far left side, we have the barometric reference port. This is connected to the optional internal barometric transducer and should be left open to atmospheric pressure. Next, we have the supply port. The pressure applied to this connection should be about 10% higher than the full scale range of the highest pressure transducer installed in the controller. The exhaust port is for the vacuum supply. In a gauge pressure version, it can be left open to atmospheric pressure. This is the vent port, where the system pressure is vented to the atmosphere under certain conditions. Leave this port open or connect the optional muffler for noise reduction. A muffler is automatically sent with all the controllers over 1000 PSI. Next is the reference port. Available to connect to the reference side of transducers, this port should be left open or connected to the DUT reference port. Never connect it to a pressure source. The measure and control port supplies pressure to the DUT managed by the controller. In the measure mode, a pressure applied to the measure and control port is measured by the internal transducers. Let's look at the top of your CPC-8000. On the lid, you can see these ventilation holes that are used by the fan to pull the air through the system for cooling. Looking at the front panel, you'll see a large color touchscreen. Push the power button to turn the unit on. Pressing it again will turn the system off. Above the power button is a USB port for future expansion or software upgrades. The front panel is hinged to allow access to the pressure transducers. To open the front panel, loosen the 2 screws near the right-hand edge of the panel. The panel can then swing open to access the transducers lined up across the interior. The CPC-8000 can be set up on a desktop or it can be rack-mounted. The rack-mount hardware is optional. The special transducers used in the CPC-8000 are relatively insensitive to tilt and vibration. However, to further assure stability and accuracy, avoid mounting the instrument on surfaces subject to excessive motor or machinery vibration. The CPC-8000 is about 50 pounds and fits in a 19-inch rack using the tray that is supplied with the rack mount configuration. If your unit isn't already on, let's power it on by using the power cord included and pressing the power button. The CPC-8000 will go through an initialization process and system check. This may take about 30 seconds. When this is completed, you will see the screen display its default features. The left side of the screen is where information like the pressure output reading, the set point, the active transducer range, units of measure, limits, and a choice between the control modes is displayed. The right side contains a keypad used for data entry, a button to access the favorite programs, and a settings button to access all other user parameters. Let's go over the features on the left side of the screen. The upper left corner of the screen shows either auto range or range hold. Although this is a 2-state button, it is not a toggle switch. When auto range is displayed, the system will automatically select the most accurate transducer available for the active system pressure. Pressing this button will also show the transducer assignment list. The active range is highlighted. Press another listed range to change it. If the CPC-8000 is under pressure, only those transducers with ranges equal to or above the internal pressure are allowed to be chosen. This large number in the middle of the screen is the pressure reading of the active transducer connected to the measure/control port. When this reading turns green, it indicates that the pressure is within a user-defined stable window. That number will be white when the pressure is outside of the stable window. A red reading indicates that the reading is 7% greater than the upper limit of the active transducer. Inherent internal safeguards are set to prevent overpressure. The setpoint button will activate a sidebar data entry method to accept a new setpoint value. You'll see it displayed here. The setpoint value can also be adjusted incrementally in the sidebar by the numeric keypad, the up and down keys, or a program. Press Setup in the sidebar to move out of the main screen and into the setup screens. Notice the bottom row of 6 subject tabs and the arrow on the left end of the row. Each tab will bring up a screen relevant to the subject in the tab title. Pressing the button to the right of the setup will display a menu with different set point options. The number pad button provides 10 digits for numeric entry, plus the decimal point and sign key. The plus and minus key will toggle between positive and negative values. Each stroke on the keypad will echo in the blue input value window above the pad. A change between plus and minus values can be entered at any time during the string entry. Pressing the check will accept the value and it will become the new set point. In the digital percentage step mode, the user can select a set point value as a percentage of the pressure range of device under test. The user can choose between various percentage values by clicking on the desired button. In the digital step data entry mode, you will see a string of 6 white zeros and 1 blue numeral, one across the top as shown in the figure to the left. Any of these zeros can be converted to a blue 1 by touching it. Use the up and down arrows to increase or decrease one digit at a time. The last button is for program data entry. After a program has been chosen by pressing the program selection button, press the play button to start the program. The stop button will stop the program and place the CPC 8000 in measure mode. The start icon is the favorites button. Here you can store routines that are frequently used. Programs that are displayed in the favorites menu are chosen in the setup screen. Located below the number pad is the screen lock and error indicator. If the error indicator is yellow, an error has been recorded. Pressing it will open the setup application where the error can be viewed. The error register will clear itself when it's viewed. However, this does not correct the error. A corrective action still must be specifically addressed. There are two data lines available in the lower portion of the main screen, reserved for the operator to display two items from a list of choices. The first line is called the secondary display, and the next line is the tertiary display. The list of choices are identical for both lines. Select the choices in the Setup General tab, then click on the secondary or tertiary display buttons. Limits are shown in three places in the main screen. The range limits, control limits, and entry limits can show two different limits, depending on settings. The range limits shows the limits of the range selected in range hold mode or the limits of the active transducer in auto range mode. The control limits are limits entered by going to the setup app, then choosing maximum or minimum limits. The control limits limit the value that can be entered as a set point. The entry limits are equal to the lesser of the control limits or the range limits. The bar graph is always active and reports in real time the pressure at the measure and control port. This provides a visual comparison between the actual pressure and the user-selected control limits. These are the pressure range units that your CPC 8000 is currently using. To change pressure units, touch the current unit symbol to display a page of the units menu in the sidebar. There are 40 predefined pressure units listed in 7 menu pages, so it may be necessary to scroll through several pages to locate the desired units. On the screen, touch either the up or down symbol to scroll to the next unit's page. Continue to scroll until the desired pressure units are found. Then, touch that line in the menu to activate the new units. The CPC 8000 has two pressure types, absolute or gauge, depending on what type of transducer is being used. If a barometer is installed, you'll be able to toggle this button between the two pressure types. The barometer is used to emulate gauge pressure when the native transducers are absolute, and absolute when the native transducers are gauge. Let's take a look at the zero cal button. If the zero calibration function is chosen in the Setup General tab, this icon will appear in the home screen. If the instrument is measuring absolute pressure, when the zero cal button is pressed, a keyboard will appear to allow a single point calibration. If the instrument is measuring gauge pressure, pressing the button will set the current reading to zero. In emulation mode, the value won't be saved to the transducer, only as a temporary adjustment. Powering off your CPC 8000 will clear this adjustment. The zero button will change to a lighter color as the zero calibration is performed, then revert back to its original color when complete. If the tear calibration function has been selected in the Display Settings app, the tear button will appear in the home screen. When the tear button is pressed, the instrument will subtract the current pressure reading so that the indicator will display zero. Subsequent deviations in pressure will be relative to the tear pressure. The button will be yellow to indicate the pressure reading is affecting the offset. Press the tear button again to deactivate it. Next, let's talk about the operating modes on the bottom of the home app. There are three modes: measure, control, and vent. The CPC 8000 defaults to measure mode, but you can change that using the mode selection keys. In measure mode, the CPC 8000 acts like a precision pressure measuring instrument and measures the pressure applied at the measure and control port. While in control mode, the CPC 8000 provides a precise pressure output at the test port. The vent button will vent the system to the atmosphere, including anything connected to the measure control port. You can configure the CPC 8000 using the Setup button. First, let's navigate to the General tab. Here you'll find language options. The secondary and tertiary display areas provide a place to indicate extra data that may be desired during test or calibration. Clicking either of these will change to a sidebar to indicate the choices that are available to each of these display areas. The Cal function button provides a selection to enable the zero button on the main screen. Selecting the zero option would enable the zero button, and selecting none would disable it. And the tear option will enable the tear button on the home screen. The brightness setting provides a sliding scale to increment the screen brightness in all screens. Sliding your finger across the bar graph or touching anywhere in the bar graph will change the brightness of the screen. Pressing volume allows you to increment the touchscreen audio feedback. The barometer button provides selection of units from a list of English or metric units presented on the right side of the screen. The barometric pressure readout can be seen on the bottom right of the main screen. This feature is only available if the optional barometric reference sensor is installed. The load button provides a place to choose a saved configuration. Choosing a configuration from the sidebar makes its parameters and settings active. Use the Save button to save configurations. Pressing it shows a list of configuration numbers displayed on the sidebar. Choose a configuration number and press the checkmark to save the CPC 8000's current settings. Next, let's navigate to the Sensor tab. Here you'll see parameters that are associated with all of the installed pressure transducers. The Filter button shows the current filter settings. The sensor filter acts on the active pressure reading on the home screen, filtering out small pneumatic and electrical variations in the pressure transducer output. The filter is set to normal by default, but can be set to off, low, or high. The resolution button shows the current resolution setting. The resolution is the number of digits that will be shown in the pressure indication within all screens of the instrument. The user can change the resolution to 4, 5, or 6 with the CPC 8000 transducers. Press the Units button to display a set of 6 selectable units and an up and a down arrow to scroll through a set of 40 different units and 2 user-defined units. Selecting any of these units will change the unit of measure for the pressure, sensed by all of the internal pressure transducers, and will also apply these units to reading taken remotely. Pressing the Rate Units button will show a choice of time denominator units, seconds, or minutes. Choosing one will apply this time denominator to all rate functions in the instrument, including the rate set point and vent rate. When this unit is changed, all rate set points are adjusted so they are mathematically equivalent to their current setting. There are several buttons with the prefixes user units. These are used to set up the base unit, and multiply are used to define user unit 1 and user unit 2. For user unit 1 and user unit 2, the process is the same. Selecting the first user unit will display a choice of PSI, bar, or pascal in the sidebar. Choosing one of these base units will form the basis of the equation that defines the user unit number chosen. Immediately below the first user unit buttons is the user unit multiplier button that indicates the current multiplier, and when pressed, will display a keypad in the sidebar where a new multiplier can be entered. Next in the setup menu is the control tab, with settings that limit elements associated with the pressure output from the instrument's regulator. The maximum and minimum limit buttons provide a place to limit the set point that can be chosen in the main screen. These limits can only be set within the range of the internal transducers. The minimum limit must be lower than the maximum limit. Both the stable limits and stable delay buttons are used to define a stable condition for pressure control or measurement. When the controller enters a stable condition, the font color for the pressure indication will change from white to green. For example, if you would like the CPC 8000 to show a stable indication only after the pressure output has been within 0.002% FS of the set point for 2 seconds, the stable limit should be set at 0.002 and the stable delay should be set at 2. The rate set point sets the rate of pressure change when the CPC 8000 is controlling up or down to a set point. The rate is limited to 0.001% of the full scale range / second to 10% of the full scale range / second. The vent limit is the pressure at which a controlled vent stops and the vent solenoid is opened, causing the pressure to vent through the vent port as quickly as possible. This should also be set within the values shown for the limits above the keypad. The vent rate is the rate at which the pressure will vent in vent mode if the active pressure is above the vent limit. This can be set within the values shown for the limits above the keypad. The Remote tab is used to choose the command set that will be used for remote communication from an external computer. Select the IEEE 488 address, configure Ethernet communication settings, and configure serial communication settings. Press the Command Set button to choose which command set to use with communication software to remotely control your CPC 8000. You can choose from the options in the sidebar. The Termination Character button provides an option for the user to select the desired termination character in the output string of the instrument. In most cases, this can be set to default, where the instrument automatically chooses the termination character based on the selected command set. Set the IEEE 488 address by pressing the button and using the keypad displayed in the sidebar. The options under the Ethernet section correspond to Ethernet parameters. Pressing any of these will present a keypad. If DHCP is turned on and a lease is obtained successfully, the Ethernet parameters are grayed and inactive but show the newly assigned lease. If a DHCP server fails to respond, DHCP will automatically turn off. Turning DHCP off allows the Ethernet parameters to be edited and a static IP address assigned. Toggle to the next page of options in the Remote tab by pressing the down arrow. This page shows the serial selections that correspond to serial communication parameters. When a parameter button is pressed, a choice selector will be presented on the sidebar, and an appropriate selection can be entered for the respective parameter. These parameters should be set up to match your host computer. Let's move to the Applications tab. All of the calibration applications are password protected. The default password for the top row of apps is 123456. To apply a single point calibration of each transducer, open the One Point Cal application. Press a button at the bottom to choose a transducer. For gauge pressure, expose the reference and the measure and control port of the CBC8000 to atmospheric pressure, and then press the New Value button and enter 0 using the keypad. For an absolute transducer, a suitable source of vacuum should be applied to the measure and control port, along with the high accuracy vacuum standard. Apply a reference pressure button between 600 millitorr and 20% of the active transducer's span to the measure and control port. Press the New Value button and then enter the reference pressure using the keypad. If you want to save the offset into the transducer, press Save. The two-point cal application is the place to adjust the transducer's zero and span. To complete a two-point cal, select a transducer to calibrate. To obtain the low point, follow the same steps again. For the high point, a reference device must be connected to the measure and control port. The system should be pressurized over 80% of the maximum range. Once stable, the high reference and actual readings can be gathered. The linearization application is a place to record upscale or downscale calibration data to linearize each transducer. A live calibration can be performed by connecting a suitable pressure standard to the measure and control port, supplying between 3 and 11 pressure points across the complete range. The pressures from the pressure standard and the corresponding reading from the instrument's transducer can be recorded into the linearization matrix. Linearization of each transducer can be performed from this screen by selecting each transducer range from the setup screen. The clear linearization selection sets linearization back to its default settings. The head correction application is a place to enter parameters that affect the offset between the device being calibrated and the transducer inside the CBC8000. Touching any of the active buttons in the screen will activate the number keypad. Each of these four rows represent a different parameter in the head correction calculation. In the height row, the level of the device under test should be subtracted from the instrument reference point and entered. The gas type used within the calibration system, the gas temperature, and the local gravity should be entered in the subsequent fields. The default height is 0, indicating that there is no head correction applied. English or metric units can be chosen at the bottom of your screen. Take a look at the next row of applications. The program screen is used to view and edit programs that are used to automatically run a sequence of commands within the CBC8000. The Display tab lets you view each program or add a new one. Pressing the program label at the top left will allow selection of predefined programs from the sidebar, plus blank labels where new programs can be entered. Use the Edit tab to edit existing programs. Pressing a command or data point will present the available commands, or a data entry selections in the sidebar. Press these buttons to insert or delete lines. Exit the edit mode with the back button. Pressing the check will accept changes, while pressing the X will revert back to the old programs. Next is the Favorites application. This is where you can choose the programs that will appear in the Home app when the button is pressed. It's there to provide quick access to the programs you use the most. These are the default list of favorites. Press one of these, then press the available programs on the right to update the favorites list with that program. The Digital I/O screen provides a place to assign conditions or actions to the digital input and outputs. By default, all inputs and outputs are turned off. Each input can be assigned to one of these choices listed on the right by pressing the input, then the choice. The key lock will lock the touchscreen and the start button will start the most recent program collected in favorites. If you run into an error, use the troubleshooting application. Here you will see information about any errors that have occurred. Push the remote settings button at the bottom of your screen to show the commands and responses that have been sent over the remote communications connection. If there are any errors in the error queue, you would see an error symbol on all screens. Pressing the error symbol will also open the troubleshooting application. The adaptation screen allows customized characterization of the CPC 8000 to deliver best performance in different conditions, like changes in supply pressure, control volume, and reference transducers. The adaptation screen allows the user to set up parameters for running the adaptation test. The configuration screen allows saving and loading each unique characterization routines to the regulator. The minimum pressure is the starting value that the needle valve regulator will be characterized for. This value may not be changed. The maximum pressure value must be set to 10% below the supply pressure connected to the supply port of the instrument and must be at least 50% of the maximum primary transducer range. You can enter the value using the keypad. Press Start to perform the control adaptation test. When it's done, the status box will display Complete. The cancel button stops the test and performs a controlled vent back to an atmospheric pressure. Restore Factory loads all of the factory settings back onto the instrument. The configuration screen stores 8 adaptation tests within the CPC 8000 for easy access in the event of change in operating conditions. The next series of applications requires a service password and contains critical aspects of the control performance. This application requires assistance from the Mentor service team and should not be adjusted unless directed by a Mentor technician. The admin screen has a place to change the calibration and service passwords. Choose the software application when upgrading instrument software from a USB device. The first button displays the software on the controller. If you have a USB drive in, you'll be able to select this button to see the available software versions on the USB drive. The second button copies the programs from the programs application to the USB drive and stores them in the root directory. Load programs stored on your USB with the Load Programs button. The Regulator Software button will display the current version of Regulator Software. When selected, a list of Regulator versions will be available for installation if they are on the USB drive. The Regulator Software should never be changed without the supervision of a Mentor service team. Use the Remove USB Device button to safely remove the USB. The status displays whether or not your USB drive is available. The last tab is the Information tab. It displays information about the instrument. Here is where you can find Mentor's address, email, model number, instrument serial number, and operating software. Here you'll find all regulator and transducer serial numbers, ranges, firmware, and accuracy information. This screen is extremely helpful to our service and/or sales team to help identify your exact product. The CPC 8000 can be ordered with different accessories. A variety of fittings are available at the time of order. The optional barometric reference transducer allows gauge mode instruments to operate in absolute mode, and similarly, absolute mode instruments to operate in gauge mode. Changing modes is easily accomplished from the front panel or over the remote interface. The CPC 8000 will either add or subtract the measurement of the installed barometric reference transducer to accomplish the appropriate emulated value. To control pressure, the CPC 8000 requires a pressure supply of 10% above the full-scale primary transducer's range of the instrument. A pressure booster can be used to generate extra supply pressure if you don't have enough source pressure. The pressure booster model 75 is an accessory that requires at least 300 PSI to operate and can generate up to 7,000 PSI. For more information on how to use Mentor's CPC 8000 high-end pressure controller, contact us at techservices@mentor.com or reach us at 512-396-4200. Mentor's pursuit of innovation and quality through continuous improvement is fueled by meeting the needs of our customers. Our partnership with you provides the framework for our excellence.